Welcome to RPUp. In this video, we'll discuss about Microsoft Power Apps or Microsoft Power Automate functionality. By using this, we will create interesting app. So here, I will show you how we can just select any image and based on that image, we will generate in Power Apps without writing or without dragging and dropping a single activity. So here simply we have to upload the image, and based on that image we will get apps generated automatically. We don't have to worry about dragging and dropping the content, and even we don't have to write a single line of code. So if you want to learn from scratch, please be here till the end of video so that you will be able to understand clearly. And if you're visiting this channel first time, don't forget to like and subscribe the channel. Now let's begin with this. Once you log in on meek.powerapps.com, here on home page you will find it out image preview. Even if you can't see it, search it from here and you'll have this options available. Now here we are converting from image to the applications. Generally we are not writing the code, simply we have to select the images, and based on that images or diagram we can generate applications without writing single line of code. And for the tips and informations, we can see this recommendations. So generally recommendations is use clearly legible forms and use one page forms, use form with the light background, use image or no larger than 4 MB. And what we cannot do it by using this. So you can just toggle it down and see the examples, what actions we can perform it. Complex forms are not allowed. Multi-page forms are not allowed. So if you want to create a multi-page form, create one by one and club it together. Now just click on next and we have this options are available. Simply we have to provide the name of project what we are automating. So here I'm just doing image to app. Upload our own image, or if we want to just try it for the sample images which is already attached, select any of the images, even the structure format which is written by the hands. So I'm just selecting with this options and going ahead with the table. Even we can select the tablet or phone format, anything which you feel better, and totally depending on the requirement. So let's go ahead with the tablet. Click on next. So once you click on next, the components will be generated. Tags applied, you can see. And even if you want, you can see the examples or guidance like this. Now here, if you want to zoom in or zoom out, and even we can fit to width as well as fit to height. So these options are available for our better user experience. Even if you want to search for the visual search, we can do this search accordingly. So here we can add the images according to our requirement. Now just click on add. As of now, I don't have a Dataverse accounts or Dataverse detail. That's why I was unable to do it. But as of now, I'm skipping this detail. Maybe in the further part or maybe in some other video, I will try to explain the Dataverse with this format. Click on create, and this will take few seconds to generate applications with the image. So get started with this. And now we have the canvas image available with the application sections. So this is loading, and here we have this nice applications generated and all the text formatting, you can see it here. So if you want to change any of the names, we can make the change. Last, let's say I just wanted to keep this field as a blank. So I will remove it, and then you can see this. But when we'll remove it here, we can't see it anything. Enter task planner, just like that. And then you will have this text box available. Task name created by this text box is available here. If you want, you can make the changes according to our requirement. Even we can select the properties, or we can change the text or number format, or even we want, we can hand text for the user point of view. Font style also, it's possible to make the changes. Font width, style, text alignments, clear button, these options are available where we can customize it according to our need. Now, let's say I want to increase the font size, so I will simply add here 18. Font width, if we want to keep the B, it means semi bold, are this options, and then you will have this option. Text alignments here, it's left. Even if we want, we can make it to right, but as of now, I'm keeping as a left only, or maybe center alignment, line height, and clear button. These options are available. It's totally depending on the needs, positions, and height. We can change it, size, padding, everything is customizable. So don't have to worry about it. In the data point of view, we have added this default text as an input, but it's totally up to us how we want to provide the detail. Maximum length, delay output, accessible label, tooltip, content language, these all options are there. Ideas, in terms of ideas, we can also take a help from the gallery. So this is how we can customize each of the fields from the left sections, and in the right sections we have the properties where we can customize the details in general as well as advanced format. By using the image, we can convert the complete image into the applications. If you want to just preview this applications, click on this and we have this options are available. So this is a very interesting features of the Power Automate or Power Apps, where we can convert complete image with just adding the image into application. So it's very simple enough. We just have to use that feature and add the images, and based on the images we can convert image to the applications without writing a single line of code. Now I'm going back to the applications, where now I was talking about the different sections which we can preview it. And even if you want to add the comments or as well as app checker, we can perform these options. In setting terms, we can change the display whichever we want. Upcoming features and the support sections are there. In general setting options, we can add app icon if we have. Otherwise, we can keep exactly same. We add images, background fill. If we want to add any background fill, that also we can enable it. Our debug published app, we have just kept off, but if we want, we can publish this app according to our need. Descriptions, we can add the description as well according to our need. Now, if I want to change the background color, simply I will make the changes from the background color. Custom color is also available, where we can customize the color according to our application page or background. Theme sections, we can keep the theme sections according to our need, like whichever is good looking, or maybe something like this rose, and we can customize it very quickly. We don't have to write a each line of code according to page. Apart of that, we can also upload the background images. So if we have the background images available, we will just simply select it, and that image will be applicable to this page. Now you can see, in previous video I've covered OpenAI with the Power Automate. So I've just added that thumbnail here. So if you want, you can add the background images as well. It's very simple enough, where we can customize our complete applications, and once it is done, we have to just publish it. And once the publishing is done, or even we can save it from here. So it's a very cool and interesting feature of creating the app without writing a single line of code, even not dragging and dropping from one place to the other place. We have just created the applications by just with the image sections. Here we can add data. In terms of data, we can create accounts, activities, child needs, so anything, whichever we want to add any informations or any data pointer, we will simply add it from here. So this is all about how to create app from just images, or how to convert image to the applications using Microsoft Power Automate. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed this. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.